Good afternoon. Welcome to the Media Box. This afternoon, you will present your report, The Reform of Football Governance in the Hemicycle of the Council of Europe. What is the origin and scope of your report?
Well, this is the third report that I've been involved in, but this is the first one I've been the reporter on for looking at the governance of football. And we started out looking at the parts of the Independent Governance Committee, or FIFA, that were not implemented by the Executive Committee and the President. And there are many things we think we need to do. They need to have more transparency. The embarrassment of Michael Garcia having to resign after his investigation report of the Ethics Committee was not properly reported by the Adjudicating Committee shows there's a huge lack of transparency. And things like publishing these reports are vital to get the credibility back that FIFA is not just run by manipulation, but actually by honesty. So that was the first thing. The second thing, of course, is the decision to give the World Cup to Qatar and the massive problem of the death of incoming construction workers from other countries, particularly from Nepal, which was over 1,000 when we started to do this report. Shocking. The human rights record of such a country had to be looked at. And the third thing, of course, is this massive amount of evidence that has been published in the press that we now have copies of. When we investigated and asked the journalists to present them, they gave us the copies of the real evidence that money was paid, bribes were paid to buy votes for Qatar for 2022. So it's corrupt, it's against human rights, and it's not been run in the way it should. That's where it all came from.
How are the sports governments and the promotion of human rights are interconnected?
Well, what has now been decided by the Olympic Committee, for example, is that they're looking at the human rights record of a country that's looking to have a major international sporting event to do with the Olympics. And that's what really should happen to everyone, because it's not really right that you allow a country to have a nice image, being able to build sports stadiums and have parades and basically pay everyone to have a nice time. And behind that, they might in fact be brutalizing their own people, or killing journalists, for example, or imprisoning journalists, or in the case of Qatar, allowing these people under the kafala system to basically be worked to death. So that's got to come into the equation now. And at last, I think we're beginning to see a change in sports governance, saying, yes, we can't just look at the sport and can they perform a good sports job, but are they a fit country to have these? And it's beginning to come together. And the IOC is the first major organisation that says they will look at this, and hopefully they will be the first to say, without a good human rights record, you do not get an Olympic sport at an international level.
Why it is so important for this report to be adopted this afternoon in the Hemicycle?
Well, this afternoon it's important because I think it sends a signal to people that we are a human rights organisation. Some people say, oh, it's all about will it affect who gets elected as a president. There's nothing in here about the president. No, it's all about how they run their organisation. Now, if it turns out that, as I think, quite frankly, that what the present president will be remembered for, Mr. Blatter, like a ball and chain around his reputation forever, will be the fact that this man allowed a corrupt process to choose a country with a terrible human rights record for a major World Cup. And I think that will never go away, and that will damage the reputation of FIFA. And we send that signal to them, regardless of how they vote in their Congress. Whoever is the president must clean up their act, must deal with this. Qatar must deal with it, we say, must deal with treating workers correctly. And bribery is never acceptable. Corrupt purchase of these organisations, great, if you like, showcases, should never be done by bribery. And the point about this, I have to say, on a memory stick, this is not a report based on newspapers. This is based on documents. These documents, we've been given every document the Sunday Times has. And we've seen them and we've read them. Corruption and bribery exist. And existed, not stories, facts.
Thank you very much, Mr. Connerty, for your answers.
Thank you.